Hello and welcome back to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. We were discussing hash tables, and hash table stores the data in key value pairs. First, hash table calculates the hash code using hash function. Hash function takes key as the input and it will outputs a hash code or hash value. Using that, you can find the index. For example, here A hash value is 97, that is the ASCII value of A. Then we'll find the index. If I take table size as 10, so we'll get index as 7. Store that in the index 7. For B, it is 98, so index is 8. Store that here, index 8. Then C, then E, and here K. For K, here you can see index 7, but index 7 is already occupied. This key value pair is already present in the index 7. So what to do in this situation? This situation is called as collusion. A situation where two different keys hash the same index is called as collusion. Then how to solve this situation? For that you can use chaining method or open addressing method. These two methods are called as collusion resolution technique. Collusion resolution is nothing but the process of handling collusion. And we have two methods, one is chaining and another one is open addressing. And first let's talk about chaining. So chaining is a collusion resolution technique. If multiple keys hash the same index, they are stored in same index or bucket, but each item is linked together. For that you can use linked list or any other data structure. So in chaining method, it allows you to store more than one key value pair in an index, but those items or key value pairs must be linked together. So here, according to the chaining method, you can store K and King here in the 7th index like this. Another method is open addressing. Open addressing is a collusion resolution technique used in the hash tables. When collusion occurs, open addressing tries to find another open slot in the hash table using probing technique. So here in the open addressing, what it will do is it won't store the multiple key value pairs in the same index. Instead of that, it will find another slot, empty slot, to store that key value pair. So for example, here we can see collusion occurred here. So here we can see the collusion. So what the open addressing will do is it will find another empty slot for this key value pair. So how it will find? It will use probing technique. Probing is a technique used in open addressing to find an empty slot in the hash table when collision occurs. So types of probing is linear probing and quadratic probing. In the linear probing, when collision happens at index I, we move sequentially to the next index. If the slot is occupied, we'll check for next one, so on until empty slot is found. So you can take index like this. Here in this example, collision occurred in the index 7, right? So what it will do is linear probing method, it will check for the next slot whether it is empty or not. Here it is not empty, it will check for next slot whether it is empty or not. No, then it will check for next slot. If it is empty, then it will store that. If it is not empty, it will search for the empty slot. Right? This is the linear probing. Then what about quadratic probing? Quadratic probing uses a quadratic function to determine the next slot to check. It will use formula like this. I value is 1, 2, 3. In this example, collision occurred at index 7. So what it will do is it will find the slot like this, index like this. So here collision occurred at 7. So it will check for 8. Next, it will check for first index. Next, it will check for sixth index like this. Okay. So these are two methods to resolve collusion. The summary of this tutorial is a situation where two different keys hash the same index. Then that situation is called as collusion. And to solve this collusion, we have two methods, that is chaining and open addressing. In the chaining, we'll store the multiple key value pairs in the same index, and in the open addressing, it will search for an empty slot to store that key value pair. And the process of handling collusion is called as collusion resolution. Okay, so this is about collusion and collusion resolution technique. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.